My dear students, welcome to the new chapter, the junk cell. In the last two online classes, we discussed about this chapter, but I want to explain once again so that through this video, if you have any doubts, the doubts can be clarified. Still, if you have any doubts, you can freely ask me through WhatsApp or Zoom in the next class. In the last two online classes, what we discussed, what we studied in this chapter. Let us have a small review and do some problems on multiplications. The junk seller is the real story of a lady called Kiran from Patna. She belongs to a poor family. She studied in Hindi medium. When she was in the school, she used to fear about mathematics. She used to hate mathematics because of these calculations, multiplications, divisions and everything. But later it was proved that these mathematics, multiplication, divisions helped her a lot in her business. In the early years, she married to a person who runs a small tea stall. When she moved to her husband's house, she saw there the husband is the only one who earns with the help of a tea stall, and mother-in-law at home, brother and sister of husband also at home, they are not going to school. She has seen the poverty. After looking all these situations, she thought that let us help the family whatever I can do. So the Kiran, the lady, started thinking what to do, which business she can do, because she has not studied much. So whatever the little knowledge she has, she want to help the family. Some people suggested, let us start a tailoring shop or a bangle store. But her uncle suggested her go for junk seller. He advised her buy junk items and sell them. Many criticized. What is this junk shop you are going to run? It is a dirty business. Ganda kaam hai. But she was convinced by her uncle, she started her own junk seller shop with the help of her mother. She took a loan of 8,000 rupees from the bank and she started her own business. By God's grace, she has tasted the success in her business. Now she is having very good pakka house, refrigerator, TV, all facilities at home, her own kids and her husband's brother and sister are all going to the school, and she is running her family, a very good family, a settled family. So this is the story of the junk seller. This is the main story. I have given the skeleton of the chapter. This is the story. In this story, where mathematics is going to come. Now let us come to the real picture. There are some simple questions I am going to ask you. You can see these questions in your textbook also. It was given in the textbook that Kiran used to hate mathematics. What about you, my dear students? Do you love mathematics? Do you love calculations? Good. I know that you all love mathematics. Which chapter is very easy to in mathematics? As the chapter is completed, as the whole syllabus gets completed, then you will get an idea which chapter is easy, which is your favorite chapter. It takes some time. As we discussed in the chapter, Kiran's husband used to run a tea stall. Do you have any idea what is the cost of a cup of tea? In a tea stall, it comes for 6 rupees or 10 rupees. Whereas in a hotel, you will get 20, 30, depends on the hotel reputation. Suppose the cost of one tea cup is rupees 6. Then what is the cost of 10 liters? What is the cost of 10 liters? Listen carefully, already you know the concept of this multiplication. Whenever the cost of one item is given and the cost of many items are required, then always we go for multiplication. Always we go for multiplication. Whenever we need a big value, cost of 10 pence, cost of 20 pence, cost of 100 pence. When big number is asked, you have to go for multiplication. So multiplication. rupees each cup, 10 cups, 6 into 10, so 60. If you are good at tables, 60 rupees is the cost. In the first class itself, I have told you, one should be ready with all 20 tables. 1 to 20, if you are good at tables, then multiplications will be easy for chutki maarke. So, practice tables, it will help you a lot. If you are good at tables, multiplication divisions will be very easy for you. Similarly, cost of one tikka in a restaurant, in a big restaurant, 20 persons. So, what about the cost of 6 tikkas? 25 into 6. I have to calculate 25 into 6. So in 6 tables, 25 won't come. 25 tables, you are not familiar. Then how to go for this multiplication? Whatever you have learned, then you have to use. 6, 5, 30, 3 here. 6, 2, 12, 12 plus 3, 15. So it is 150 rupees. Simple multiplications. The whole chapter, in this whole chapter, we are going to come across multiplications of these types. When cost of one thing is known, what is the cost of 5 things, 6 things, 10 things? So everything multiplication. Multiplication of one digit with 2 digits. Multiplication of one digit with 2 digits. We are going to learn multiplication of 2 digits with 2 digits also in this chapter. Okay. One more question that we discussed in today's class. Suppose a person earns rupees 30 per day from a tea stall. Then how much is going to earn in 10 days and in 30 days? He earns rupees 30 per day. We need his earning for 10 days. So one day rupees 30 for 10 days. When big number is asked, you have to go for multiplication. So 30 rupees for one day for 10 days. 30 into 10. You can go for multiplication. 10. 10 into 0 is 0. 0 into any finite number. 0 into any number is always 0. Remember this. 10 into 0 is 0. 10 into 3. 30. So 300 rupees. Am I clear? The same question was discussed in today's class. If you have not gone through it clearly, then you can go through this. You can take down this. This not right in the class book. One day earning rupees 30, then earning in 10 days will be 30 into 10, 300. Second question is asking for 30 days. He is asking what is the earning for 30 days. The earning for 30 days, 30 into 30. Now how to do this 30 into 30? 30 multiplied by 30. 30 multiplied by 30. 0 into 0, 0 into 3. Leave this space. This is the method to multiply a 2 digit number with a 2 digit number. 3 into 0, 3 into 3, 9. Now add. Here we are not doing anything, that we leave the space. So 0, nothing is there. 0, 0 plus 0, 9. 900. So this is the answer. 900 is the answer. 900. So multiplication of a 2 digit number with a 2 digit number. To get more practice, let us do some multiplications. 12 into 15. What is the answer? 12 into 15. 12 into 15. 5 2 is 10. 5 1 is 5. 5 plus 1, 6. Or directly 5 into 12, 12 is 16. Once multiplication is done with 5, you have to go for 1, then you have to leave this space. 1 into 2, 1 into 1. This is the answer. Multiplication of a 2 digit number with a 2 digit number has to be done with a lot of care. Multiplication of two digits with one digit you might have learned. Some people may be knowing this also. Multiplication of a two digit number with a two digit number. Those who are not have any idea. This is the method. So write number and another number here. Multiply with 5, 2, 1, then 1, 2, 1. Multiply and get this. To get more practice, let me do some more questions on this. Once multiplication is clear to you, then whole chapter will be easy. 18 into 12. What is the answer? 18 into 12. 2, 8, 16. 2, 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 1, 8, 8. 1, 1, 1. 216. 6, 8 plus 3, 11, 1 plus 1. Two digit number with a two digit number. This is the method what I have learned that I am teaching to you. If you have learned any alternate method, if you are comfortable with that method, you are allowed to use that method. No compulsion. I am doing in this way. If any other method giving the same answer, if you are familiar, if you have learned, no compulsion, you can use that method. Finally, we should know the method, we have to learn the method, we have to execute in the exam, we have to get the marks. That is important. If your method is correct, it is always allowed. Okay, let us try one more question. Some big numbers are here. 36 into 24. 36 into 24. 4, 6 is 24. 4, 3 is 12. So you add 14 and 8. Next with 2. First 4, 6 is 4, 3 is multiplication. How we do 36 into 4? That was done and got the answer. Next with 2. 2 into 6. 2, 6 is 12. 2, 3 is 6. 7. You have to leave this space. Always start from here. Leave this. Now add 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 7 plus 1, 8. That's answer. 4, 6, 8. This is the answer. I think I'm clear. Okay? This is how we do multiplication of a two-digit number with a two-digit number. Write these numbers. Try these multiplications and verify the answers yourself. Multiply, get the answers, check the answers with the help of others or calculators and check whether it is right or wrong. Okay? So if you are comfortable with multiplication of a two-digit number with a two-digit number, then the whole chapter will be easy for you. Now coming back to the chapter. As I said, the lady Kiran, she started a junk seller shop with the help of her mother-in-law by taking a loan of 8,000 rupees from the bank. 8,000 rupees loan from the bank. Now here, the word loan, since you are kids, you may not be having any idea about the loan. Let me explain, what is the loan? Loan means amount you are borrowing from the others. Others means it can be from the bank or financial institutions or from the persons who generally lend the money, or it is a hand loan taken from your friends or relatives. It is called loan. Suppose you are not having sufficient amount in your pocket, but you want to buy something, you want to invest something, you want to do something, further you need money. The money what you are having in your pocket is not sufficient. Then generally what you will do? You will ask one of your known persons to lend the money. You will ask, give the money. Afterwards, I will give. Whereas in the bank, when you approach the bank, bank will give the money. you have to return the money in a particular time period with interest. It is not that whatever you have taken, you have to return it back. That is not the case of bank or financial institutions. Maybe your close friend, your relative may give the money and he will return in 1 or 2 days or a few days. When you are going for a long period, then bank or finance organizations, they always expect interest from you. If you take some money, you have to return the money, and in addition to that money what you have taken, you have to pay some interest also. Okay, that interest depends on the bank to bank. When you take from the bank, you have to repay less amount, including interest. When you take from others or financial institutions or lenders, then you have to return money, it will be more. One simple example is mentioned in our textbook, Hariya and Bapu. For example, Hariya has taken 300 rupees to buy handcraft. Bapu has taken 300 rupees for the same purpose. But he approached the bank. Bank has given loan to him 300 rupees. He has to repay in 6 months and monthly 51 rupees. So total how much is going to pay? Monthly 51 rupees, but for 6 months is paying. 6 months, 306. Whereas Babu has taken 300 rupees, monthly he is not paying anything because he has taken from Chunnila, a private financier. And the agreement was done that after 6 months, he has to pay 306 rupees. Bulk amount. 300 taken, 360 giving back. Who is paying more? This person Hariya taken from bank, he is returning 306 rupees, where he is giving 360. So he is paying more. So whenever you approach bank, your rate of interest will be less. If you approach private financiers, you have to pay more. Let us not go in detail about this private finance and everything. Loan means when you need an extra amount or additional amount, then you will approach the bank. Bank will sanction the loan as per your capacity, repaying capacity and everything, as per your credentials. When you take the money from the bank, you have to return the bank in monthly installments, not at a time. So you take the money, you start your own business, get the profit, then return to the bank. Exactly the same thing was done by Kiran. She has taken 8,000 rupees from the bank and she started her own business, junk seller. She used to purchase the junk items and she used to sell the junk items to the others who required this, and she used to get the profits. She cleared the loan. Now she is living a happy life. Junk. What do you mean by junk? Junk means the things which are not in use, which are thrown out, which are not in use. You might have seen in your home newspapers, old newspapers. What you will do? You read the paper today, then you will keep aside. After a few days, you will sell the newspapers. The new newspaper of the today, it may cost 6 rupees. 6 rupees, one newspaper of today, as I know in Hyderabad. But after 4 or 5 months, the old newspapers, everything, if you want to sell, then the junk seller will take the newspapers, kilo 10 rupees or 20 rupees or 30 rupees. So the used items, if you want to sell, there will be no value for that. Even if the value exists, it will be very, very less. Items can be sold for very less cost. So all these items, whatever you are selling, second-hand items, not in use, repaired items, all these are called junk items. Junk sellers buy all these and they will process it and they will sell to the companies who need components of these junk items. So Kiran started the junk seller shop and she has tasted success in her business. Few more questions, few more topics are there that we are going to discuss in the next class. If you have any doubts, then again I will post a video. With the help of that video, you will get the clarity. Whatever the questions discussed here, you practice once again. Those you are not comfortable in the Zoom class, those you attended late, those not able to understand because of the internet problem or any technical issues, if there is no clarity in the voice, this video may help you a lot. Okay, so let us meet in the next class.